Data engineer is a key role in any data-driven insight or initiative. Now, when I talk about insight, the insight can be any form. It can be an insight generated via simple dashboard or simple reports, or it can be insight generated via predictive analytics. It can also be insight generated via advanced analytics and data mining. So data engineer plays an important role in any of the consuming application and insight application. What are the typical skills required for data engineer? Now, if you see from data engineer, if you see the diagram over here, basically this is the inverted triangle data lifecycle. If you see on the top, the data is pretty large and across the organization and federated across the organization. And as you go into the insight cycle and the action cycle, the data basically reduces its footprint. Now, if you see a data engineer typically plays an important part in the top life cycle. So basically they are involved in collecting this terabytes and petabytes of data across the enterprise and then integrating it, basically acquiring it and then curating the data. So the data can be in multiple form, the data can be in multiple systems, it can be a mainframe system, it can be a traditional database, or it can be any file system, any structured unstructured format. So the key purpose of data engineer is taking all the data and collecting the data, centralizing it sometimes, and further taking the centralized data and then curating the data and making it consumption ready. That is the key role of data scientists. And during this process, they have to perform multiple activity, like they have to take care of data security, they have to take care of data quality, they have to take care the lineage of the data is maintained, the metadata is captured. There are multiple aspects comes into play when we talk about the data governance cycle of it. So this is the typical work done by data engineering. Now coming to specifically the skills. So a data engineer must understand the different architectures of organizing the data. It can be via a data lake, or it can be via a data warehouse, or it can be any other form. Typically, the data lake and data warehouse are widely used across enterprise. So they need to understand the data architecture. They need to understand data processing techniques, either using Apache Spark, or it can be traditional SQLs, or it can be ETL frameworks like Informatica or Talend. Now, why I say SQL in specifically, most of the system today is moving towards an SQL based mode of basically extracting and processing data. Earlier when Hadoop came in, it was more like a MapReduce based framework. But again, the industry is moving back to SQL based framework. So they need to understand the data processing technique. They need to also understand one of the cloud providers. Today, a lot of data is gravitating towards cloud. Knowing one cloud and knowing the cloud specific products, being more cloud native, if it's Google Cloud Platform, then knowing Google Cloud Data Proc or Data Flow or PubSub, it's pretty important. Similarly, in AWS, there are similar set of technologies. So knowing one of the cloud platform is pretty important, as most of the data is moving to cloud over time. Now, in addition, they also need to understand different patterns like real-time data acquiring pattern and processing pattern. They need to understand batch, mini-batch, and even service-based pattern. The more and more data today is getting real-time. It's like the time wasted in acquiring data is kind of wasting money in the leaving money in just like that for somebody to pick it up. So the more sooner we collect data, the more we are able to acquire new customers and save more money for the business. So understanding the real-time patterns is also pretty key. Knowing NoSQL, couple of NoSQL platform, when it comes to low latency, serving the data and everything, understanding some NoSQL platform is key. And if you're specifically from the data architecture side of it, understanding designing of systems, specifically when it comes to NoSQL, how to model a particular system, how to flatten out the data structures. So more like designing both from the data lake, data architecture and NoSQL platform is pretty key. So that's about it. Now, I will continue and provide insight for other roles as well as we go on, mostly on the data analyst and other similar roles. Thank you.